Dear students, welcome back to our English class. We had completed our lesson 2 of unit 3. Listen to the mountain written by Kaveri Nambishan. Now, let's move on to the review of the play and some of the activities of this lesson. Let's keep in our mind some of the points to write the review of the play. First, there should be an introduction. In the introduction, you should include some basic facts about the story, including the title, the author,
the story genre, which means child.
Summarize the story briefly, then personal reflection should be there, then critical analysis, then at last conclusion. Now, let's move on to each point in detail. A dramatic form of short story is known as play or drama. So a short story is fiction in prose that has a fully developed theme but is less elaborate and has fewer characters than a novel. The average short story is no longer than 10,000 words. So if you are required to write a short story review or a review of a play, you have to understand that you should express your own thoughts, provide critical analysis and evaluate a particular subject within the text. The next point is summary. Briefly summarize a story. Discuss the setting, the main characters and the main events or problems that the characters experience. Don't give the ending away. The next point is a personal reflection. Discuss what you like or dislike about the story. Give reason to support your opinion. You may want to compare and contrast the story with other stories you have read by the same author
or on the same genre.
You can also compare the story to your own personal experience or a current event in the news. Then the critical analysis. In the critical analysis, some questions to explore are: what is the author's purpose for writing the story? Is the author successful in achieving this purpose? What is the setting of the story?
Is it appropriate to the genre?
How well are the characters developed? Do they think, feel, speak and act in a believable way? These are the questions in the critical analysis that you can ask and find answer. Then the conclusion. In the conclusion, you should evaluate the story and either recommend it or not recommend it to others, depending on whether you think it is worthwhile reading. Remember, before you begin writing the review, make sure you read the story closely and take good notes. I hope that it's clear for you and try to write the review of the play. The second activity is write-up. You have to prepare a write-up. So what are the points to remember? There should be a suitable title. Begin with a striking idea. Sequencing of ideas, use of varied sentences, appropriate conclusion. So here the topic is Kannan's words, tourist means money and who doesn't need money. So here are some tips to help you to write this, and after writing it you have to evaluate, is your write-up is well organized, attractive, logically arranged, etc. Okay, now look at the third activity. It is a debate. What is a debate? Yes, a formal discussion on a particular topic in a public meeting in which opposing arguments are raised in a democratic manner. Your grandmother and Dikshit both having different opinion. No? So a debate is a structural argument. Two sides speak alternatively for and against a particular contention, usually based on a topical issue. Unlike the arguments you might have with your family or friends, each person here is allocated a fixed amount of time to speak. Any interference is carefully controlled. The subject of the dispute is often prearranged, so you may find yourself having to support opinions with which you don't normally agree. You also have to argue as part of a team, being careful not to contradict what others on your side have said. So these are the things you should keep in your mind while doing a debate. Next one is email. What's an email? For most of us, email is the most common form of business communication. So it's important to get it right. Although emails usually aren't as formal as letters, they still need to be professionals to present a good image of you and your company. How to write a formal email? Follow these 5 simple steps to make sure your English emails are perfectly professional. So these are the points you should keep in your mind. Begin with a greeting, thank the recipient, state your purpose, add your closing remark, end with a closing. So always open your email with a greeting such as "Dear Susan" if relationship with the reader is formal. If it is informal, you can simply say "Hi Sonia." If you don't know the name of a person you are writing to, use "to whom it may concern" or "Dear Sir or Madam." Then being based stated your purpose. For example, "I am writing to inquire about," "I am writing in reference to." So make your purpose clear early on in the mail and then move into the main text of your email. Remember, people want to read email quickly. So keep your sentences short and clear. You will also need to pay careful attention to grammar, spelling and punctuation so that you present a professional image of yourself and your company. The next one is thanks the recipient. If you are replying to a client's inquiry, you should begin with a line of thanks. For example, someone has a question about your company, you can say "thank you for contacting ABC company." Someone has replied to one of your email, be sure to say "thank you for your prompt reply" or "thanks for getting back to me." Thanking the reader puts him or her at ease and it will make you appear polite. So before sending your mail, it's polite to thank your reader one more time and add some polite closing remarks. You might start with "thank you for your patience and cooperation" or "thank you for your consideration," and then follow up with "if you have any question or concern, don't hesitate to let me know and I look forward to hearing from you." The last step is to include an appropriate closing with your name. "Best regards, sincerely," and "thank you, all are professional." Avoid closing such as "best wishes" or "cheers" unless you are intimate with the reader. Finally, before you hit the send button, review and spell check your email one more time to make sure it's truly perfect. So here there is a question for you. Try to do it with the above mentioned steps. Okay. Now look at the activity 5, Reader's Theatre. Reader's Theatre is a dramatic presentation of the written work in a script form. Readers read from a script and reading part are divided among the readers. No memorization, costume, blocking or special lighting is needed. Presentation can easily be done in a classroom. Scripts are held by the readers. Through this activity, students have the opportunity to develop fluency and further enhance comprehension of what they are reading. So scene 1, 2, 3, 4. You should pay attention to the following while reading aloud. Good voice modulation should be there, correct pronunciation, meaningful pauses wherever necessary, right tone and expression. So if you pay attention to the above mentioned points, you will be able to present it effectively in front of your class. Okay. So we had gone through the important activities of this lesson. I hope you understood. If there is any doubt, you can ask me. Go through the activities once again. Thank you.